Thank you, Michelle, and thank you, Günther, for your nice introduction. Yes, as you said, I will speak a few words about the National Institute for Aerospace Technology. This is the reference center in Spain for space activities. And, well, we are a really big institute. It was founded in 1942, more than, well, almost 80 years ago. It is located here in the vicinity of the airport in Madrid. But it is spread all over Spain. We have facilities all over Spain for aerospace in general. There are a number of projects related to aerospace science, but I will focus mostly on the projects that are being run by the CAB, by the Center for Astrobiology. This is a joint institute between the INTA and the National Research Council, CESIC. And, well, our idea is basically we want to understand what is the origin and evolution of life along the history of the universe. So the three main questions: how, where, and when did life emerge? How did it evolve towards intelligence and consciousness? And what is the future of life on Earth and beyond? And our strategy for that is basically to start from the very beginning. At the very beginning is very long time ago. It's at the beginning of the universe. We come here to start the production of hydrogen, the production of elements, the production of galaxies, the production of other stars with exoplanets around them, the emergence of life at least around 5 billion years ago here on Earth, the emergency of complex life and intelligence not so long away, and the present time. So basically, this diagram represents all what we do from the very beginning here at the beginning of time, the different steps in the evolution of the universe, where the different elements were formed, the structures, the satellite, the galaxies, the planets, and finally, the primordial life was formed here on Earth. How do we do it? Well, we follow a multi and transdisciplinary approach. This means that we put together to work people on astrophysics, on geology, on planetology, on biology, on planetary exploration and engineering. And we complement all this with the simulation chambers. We can simulate almost any condition in the solar system. In any planet, in any moon of the solar system, we can reproduce the conditions and analyze what is happening there, what is the evolution of a molecular compound if you put it there. And we can predict what happened on comets, on Titan, on the surface of Mars, on any place on the solar system. We were founded around 20 years ago. And well, we have a close collaboration with INTA and also a close collaboration, scientific collaboration with CESIC. We are associated to the NASA Astrobiology Institute, and we are also collaborating with ESA. We have a second building, a second laboratory, located at the European Space Astronomy Center here, very close to Günther, indeed, here close to Madrid. We have a number of laboratories. I will not go into the details, but well, you have here some pictures of what the people are doing in the headquarters of CAP in Torrejón de Ardoz. We are simulating the collisions of asteroids with this project Canon. These are the different planetary condition simulation chambers. And I want to summarize you what are the space mission in which we are involved. We started already more than 20 years ago with Integral. We are responsible for the optical monitoring camera on Integral, which is in operation already since 2002, 18 years, working, taking images every minute. So it is really impressive. And this is some examples of what we can do with this instrument, monitoring the variability of different stars. Not all the stars in the universe are stable and constant. Many of them show strong variations. In some cases, the variations are periodical, like these ones, sinusoidal, or they can be of any kind. And this is what we are doing for thousands of, hundreds of thousands of stars continuously. We are also working on the James Webb Space Telescope. We have one instrument scientist of the NISPEC instrument, and we made a significant contribution to the MIRI telescope simulator. This is expected to fly next year, we hope. and it will be really the flagship of the astronomy at world level. A very big telescope, 6.5 meters in diameter, working very far away from the Earth in a very stable and very clean condition, which will be really tremendous. We have also a strong contribution to the Plato mission. The Plato mission will be launched in 2027, well, depending on what Gunther decides, but around 27, more or less, let's say, plus minus 1 year. And it will be the first mission to be able to find and characterize planets similar to the Earth in the habitable zone of stars similar to the Sun. So we are going to find for the first time duplicates of the Earth. And we are not only to find, but also to characterize, to know the density, the properties, the existence of an atmosphere, the existence of oceans. And depending on how many we find, this will be the ground for future explorations in the 30s, looking for biosignatures to some traces of life. We are also contributing to the next big X-ray telescope of ESA, Athena. And we have several instruments now on Mars, physically on Mars, working there. This is one, REMS. This is a meteorological station working there on the surface of Mars since 2012. This is a real picture taken on the surface of Mars. And here they are hidden, but you can find some sensors. This is one of the temperature sensors. And there are sensors all over the spacecraft. Since 2018, we have a second meteorological station working on the surface of Mars, which is TWINS. These are also real pictures taken there on the surface of Mars of the instrument. Here you see again the temperature sensors. And we have also, we made a significant contribution to the MIX telescope. It's an X-ray telescope on Bepi Colombo, which is a mission which is now cruising to Mercury. As Gunther has said, it was flying Venus last week. And it's on its trip to Mercury. It will arrive on 2025. In space astronomy, you have to be very patient, indeed. And we have a third meteorological station, a very big, a very powerful one, MEDA, which was launched to Mars a few months ago. It's now flying to Mars, and it will arrive in February 2021, we hope. In 2 years from now, a Raman the spectrometer will be launched on board the ESA's ExoMars mission, and it will be, it will try to look for biosignatures on the surface of Mars. Not only on the surface, but also in the underground of Mars. This is not flying yet. This is a detector of life, and this is something we are developing, and we hope to be able to launch to Mars within this decade. This is a real nice instrument which should be able to detect biological activity on the surface of Mars or any other planet. These are some testing here on Atacama, here on the Earth. And more in the future, another possibility is to send a similar instrument to Europa. Europa is a moon of Jupiter. It has a liquid ocean below a very thick crust of ice. And there are some evidences that there could be biological activity in this ocean. And you can see here that water from this ocean emerge from time to time on fountains, on geysers. And analyzing the chemical compounds on these geysers, we should be able to find traces of life. This is still in the project. This is for the end of this decade, for maybe next decade, but it is our intention to go there and look for life. Some numbers, we are around 150 scientists. INTA as a whole has 2,200 scientists and engineers. Well, we are publishing around 200 refereed publications per year and get money from everybody who wants to fund us. The main building is at INTA in Torrejón de Ardoz, close to the airport. But I am now speaking to you from our secondary building here at the ISAC facilities in Villafranca del Castillo, where the CESAR initiative is run. We are collaborating with CESAR for 30 years already. A small laboratory was installed here in Villafranca, and we have a close collaboration with everybody here, especially within the CESAR project. So I wish you a very interesting course this week, and I am sure you will learn a lot about the space astronomy. Thank you.